Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about cross elastics. I realize I had no videos on cross elastics. You guys have been asking about cross elastics, so I'm going to go over them. So there's two different types of cross elastics. There's ones for a Brody or a scissor bite, and there's ones for a posterior cross bite. Obviously, in this picture, you can see these are cross elastics. They go from the inside of the bottom to the outside of the top. These are going to be for Brody bites or scissor bites. And those are relatively predictable, assuming. Again, this is kind of when I use them. So I don't put them on. A lot of you guys are trying to rush and put them on from day one. Absolutely not. There's just no point in that. All you're gonna do, patients hate these. All you're gonna do is burn them out on elastics, and it's often not even necessary. So first of all, anytime you have a Brody case, you got to say, is it a dental crossbite or a skeletal crossbite? In a true Brody bite, skeletal, scissor bite, skeletal crossbite is very, very, very rare. I don't know that I've maybe seen it, but a handful of times. That means that the lower arch bone is so constricted and the upper arch bone is so wide that it's just entrapped. And remember, we always want our teeth to be perpendicular to the ridge, and we really can't grow lower ridges in an adult. In a kid, maybe a little bit. In that case, you're going to want to try to widen the arch to get it to match up. And an adult, if it truly is just two different sizes, if there's got to be some type of major asymmetry, you're probably going to have to do some type of jaw surgery to get that to fit together. Simply tipping the upper teeth in and tipping the upper lower teeth out is not healthy for those teeth, because you're not putting them along the long axis of the bone, which is going to make them at risk for abfractions, wear, abnormal forces, abnormal loading. You know, that's not great. So you need to pick your case wisely in this situation. Also, if it was a situation where let's say you did some upper expansion and you blew it out too much, you know, you blew it out way too much on top, and now you're just trying to integrate the bite, I would just go through your normal level in the line. I would bond the upper sevens or second molars, try to integrate the bite with some posterior box elastics. It should settle in no problem for the most part, if it's like this where your top teeth are blown out, right? And then maybe the lower teeth are rolled in. We're just going to integrate the bite. Now, of course, if it's the flip and it's a posterior cross bite where the upper ridge is smaller than the lower ridge and it's an adult and we can't do skeletal expansion, you're probably SOL. You probably do not even want to mess with that. Just leave the posterior crossbite. I mean, yeah, there's vivos and there's all kinds of marpies, but that's not stuff I teach in my consulting practice. This is surgical, and I don't believe in educating people on surgical techniques through YouTube. So I would just leave it. The risks outweigh the benefits. Let a proper orthodontist and oral surgeon work up a surgical case for that case. That's nothing that a general dentist or a pediatric dentist should be getting into. That's a different situation. And you certainly don't want to be messing with the cross elastics, which, by the way, would be opposite. They go from inside upper to lower, outside lower, to try to fix them. But if it is a dental crossbite, it should easily be able to fix just by coordinating your wires. Another quick trick you could do for a situation like that is you could theoretically flip-flop. Oh, actually, let's talk about it the other way. If you had a situation like this where you were just trying to quickly widen the lower to try to integrate with the top, you could put an upper wire in the lower. That does help, you know, with some seating elastics as well, like triangle elastics, overlapping triangles. That helps really, really well. You don't want to leave that in forever, but just as a quick fix, it does help. All right, hopefully that was helpful. So anyways, in a nutshell, don't mess with cross elastics till the very, very, very end after you've bond sevens, and pick your cases wisely. Make sure the bones are going to fit together. If they're not going to fit together, don't bother using cross elastics. Just leave it. All right. Thanks.